Yes, indeed. We're discussing sports now, and George Aluo is an editor, sports editor, who joins us on Sunrise Daily this morning. Thank you so much indeed. And let's focus on that UEFA. You watched that match. Interesting to see Man City against Liverpool, 3-0. It was blazing all the way. Not too many people were expecting that.
Yes, because if you look at the current form of Man City, they thought they would have made a mincemeat of Liverpool. Just one game in the EPL, just one other win, they'll be talking about being EPL champions. But don't forget that in Europe, it's going to be a different ballgame, because we're not talking of EPL here. Mm. Liverpool has got the pedigree in Europe, and they proved that yesterday. And if you look at their first game this year, way back in January, the way that 7-goal trailer, 4-3, it ended with Liverpool winning, you know that Man City was not going to have it easy yesterday. So I saw it coming. But the way they decimated Man City shows that Liverpool, their win in January was not a fluke. They were the first
to
stop
it. Although this is the first leg.
This is the first leg at the Etihad. Exactly.
How do you see them performing at the Etihad?
Well, I want to give it straight away. I want to put my money on Liverpool, Gimba. Because
again?
Yes. Because if Man City had done what they did in the EPL, that of coming from behind to at least cancel some of the goals, because if you remember in January, Liverpool was leading by 4-1, but literally they scored some goals. They tried to do that yesterday, but you see that Liverpool defended very well, ensured that they didn't concede. So they are going into the second leg now without conceding a goal at home, at Anfield. So that is a good one for them. It is a tall one for Man City now. They have to score as many as 4 goals without Liverpool replying.
And, Pep Guardiola.
A team that has Salah, a team that has Sadio Mane, 2 Africans. I was really impressed with their performance yesterday. They not only scored, just like they did way back in January, 2 of them scored in that first EPL game. Yesterday night again, they scored. And you saw that these two, I was even looking at the game from the prism of the World Cup, because we're talking, this is a World Cup here.
Yeah, of course.
And I'm happy with the current form of Salah for Egypt, and the Sergio Mano for Senegal.
Brilliant performance he had just yesterday.
And today in the
if you have to look at the coaches, you're looking at Pep Guardiola, and you're looking at Jurgen Klopp. On the other hand, how much of this two expertise do you think will come to bear? Because a lot of people are now counting, okay, these are two great teams, two English sides, but when we move to that point, what will make the difference when it comes to the coaches?
Well, coaching has a lot to do with it. Pep Guardiola, forget what happened yesterday, good coach. He has proven that. He's having a good run in the EPL. But yesterday was a bad night for him. And it happens to
clearly a bad night, so we cannot forget that one.
Yes,
the fans will not forgive him for that.
And then Jurgen Klopp on his part, good manager. I think he read Man City very well. He knew their weak points. He told his boys to attack from the beginning. They had the pace which Man City could not match. That is what made the difference. If you look at the pace, the intensity of the game, they came out fighting. And when you are hungry, you get what you want. I think that was what went for Liverpool yesterday night. Not too many persons gave them a chance, but they knew what they wanted and they knew how to go about it. And
if we have to look at their formation, for instance, especially when we're going for the second leg, and since you're very confident that they are giving it to Liverpool already, you're looking at their formation. See, let's talk about the offense.
Liverpool, interestingly, is not a side that sit back like Chelsea to defend. I don't expect them packing the bus when they go to the Etihad. I don't expect them to do that. They will still come out attacking, and a team that has a vibrant attack like Firmino, like Sadio Mane, like Salah, you don't expect them to sit back, pack the balls that the way Chelsea would do. They will still attack, and there's no way they will not get a goal.
You know, what's the secret of the Egyptian that makes him just so outstanding in the UEFA this time?
I think I saw him at the Atiokaf Award in Ghana in January. In fact, himself and Sadio Mane, they were there. They were the two top nominees for the award. And he said one thing that he told me that one thing that keeps him going is the fact that he wants to win, that he's hungry to win, and he wants to dedicate every victory to Egyptian children. I mean, he is somebody that said he loves kids that are coming after him, so he wants to be a role model, and he wants to be the best in Africa. That was talking about Salah when he won the African Footballer of the Year. And if you look at him, on current form, he is devastating. And I hope he carries this form to the World Cup for Egypt.
Do you think that can also be said about Sadio Mane?
Same thing with Sadio Mane. Sadio Mane literally qualified Senegal for the World Cup. We saw the replayed game against South Africa in Johannesburg. He was the one that did the damage. So the two of them are in good form at the moment, and I think it's good for Africa beyond what they are doing for their club anyway, Gimba.
So at this point now, if we have to look at our preparing, looking at the next leg at the Etihad, what would you say would be the strong point for Liverpool going in there?
The strong point for Liverpool is that they have a very vibrant attack. And one other thing is that Man City will want to come out fighting, cancel the goals. Yesterday, they were very poor. Gabriel Jesus, at a point, he got frustrated and he got a yellow. Raheem Sterling, he was caged. So I think in the second leg, they will want to come out attacking. And if they do that, they'll be vulnerable again in